Hi everyone, this is the Redwood Theater. We will be holding the Tesla Medicine Show this June 14th, 15th, and 16th. And we are so excited to welcome all sorts of incredible exhibitors, healers, practitioners. You get to experience Tesla's medicine and how it's applied to so many different inventions that we're going to be having right here.
In the universe, there is a core from which we obtain knowledge, strength, and inspiration. If you want to find the secret of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration.
Magnetic energy is the secret, and Nikola Tesla used it as medicine.
Tesla created the electromagnetic power grid and the way power is distributed through North America.
We are surrounded by magnetical fields which are covering the natural magnetical field. So we have a loss of natural energy. With a result, we are becoming sick.
I live a life of seclusion. The opinion of the world does not affect me.
He also discovered he could use them to heal himself in smaller dosages.
It's absolutely amazing.
There's no side effect by adding more frequencies.
The wave frequency of the human cavity resonates between 6 and 8 hertz.
Tesla has developed a special coil. We in the electronic area, we are producing cylinder coils. And Tesla developed a coil which is like a pancake. And a lot of secret things happens with this Tesla coil, also in the medical area.
Tesla's round and flat spiral coils are now inserted inside mats, pads, probes, and glass.
We use it for increasing circulation, and they have not a second of pain.
A back pain, for example, headache.
I've been sick for 3 years. I can't live life like this.
And literally, I laid on a mat for 3 days, and it was gone. And I says, this is a miracle. Why doesn't the world know about this?
That's a big subject.
It's my decade-long journey in search of Tesla's lost inventions. Read rare archives of how Tesla coils were energized using secret frequencies of magnetic fields. It's called frequency therapy. I documented here how it all started and how it is used in secret to this very day. Join me for a thought-provoking exploration in search of Tesla's medicine.
If that was so effective, wouldn't everybody be using it? Well, they would if they knew what it was, but they've never heard of it. They don't even know about it. Who would think that something as simple as slapping your body on an area for 5 minutes until it gets all the crap out of it would actually be something that would heal your body profoundly? So a lot of people see me use this little tool that's called the Exhibitors. And this is a very simple tool that you operate on your own body. If you want to talk about energy medicine, for example, there's all kinds of devices you can spend anywhere from $5,000 to $50,000, and they call it energy medicine, whether it's pulse electromagnetic frequency, light therapy, sound therapy, there's all kinds of things out there. This is by far the most effective energy medicine device on Earth, and it works with a stimulation of the skin. Now, it creates percussion. Like, say, for example, you have a shoulder that's bothering you. You simply, on the skin, you just start to use the Exhibitors like this, and you just stay on that one area for 5 minutes. If nothing is wrong with your shoulder, this does absolutely nothing because you're good. But when there's something wrong, there's an inflammatory congestion problem in your shoulder, it'll start to light on fire. It will swell up. It will turn color. It will be painful in the treatment. That indicates that you have something inside your body that you should not have, and people will wear out their joints, their shoulders, their hips, and their knees is what wears out in people's lives. Now, this also works with meridians. For example, if somebody's having a heart attack, okay, that's pretty extreme, but if you're having a heart attack, you slap right on the inside of the left elbow. This is the major meridian to your heart and your lungs. So they will stop the heart attack immediately. Every ambulance should have these in there. You can also use your hand, okay? But the hand is not nearly as efficient. This is a silicone little hand on a metal rod And it took me years to finally find this thing and understand the best possible tool to get. You go up to a rock and slap the rock, nothing's going to happen because it's not alive. It's not going to swell up. It's not going to heat up. It's not going to do anything. Your body, because you're a living being and you have congestion in your body, is going to light up when you first do it. Once you get everything cleared for your heart and your lungs through this meridian, then you go back and do it later, nothing happens. First time you do it, it's like, whoa, this is like, what's going on? So you want to use this throughout your whole entire body. If you're a professional athlete, for example, you can prevent injuries with this, and you can also support the body's ability to heal the injury in a 10 times shorter time frame than the body would normally heal. So when you use this tool on your knee, for example, and you do like every part of your knee all the way around, which takes multiple treatments, you get all of the congestion out of there. You're stimulating the brain to send stem cells to the site. It's like tearing a building down and getting it rebuilt from the ground up. Then the knee doesn't get injured again, because now your knee's not going to get injured because you decongested that part of your body. Now, this is an extremely important thing for everyone. Doesn't matter who you are. I look at all the old people walking around today, and I'm supposed to be called an old person. What a joke. I'm like a 25-year-old. I've gone through my body on all the major joints. I have zero pain, zero stiffness. I can rip around like a young man. And I wasn't that way before I learned about this. I had major injuries when I was younger because I worked in the oil field for 17 years. I had a knee injury so bad on my left knee when it was crushed when I was 21 in a very serious accident. I thought it healed, but I knew it wasn't fully healed because I had more and more pain over my lifetime and I couldn't twist my knee at all. I'd have to watch even going down a set of staircases to the left, make sure I didn't twist my knee or it would blow up like a basketball for a week. If I would go to an auditorium or a theater where I couldn't put my legs straight, I would have to leave within 20 minutes because the pain increased so much. When I did the treatment with the Activator in 2018 and 2019, my knee was totally 100% healed and I have zero pain in my knee now. And so when I watch all these old people walking around limping, you see their hips are bad, their knees are bad. Then they go get a knee replacement or hip replacement. Those things are not required anymore. You can completely fix your own body with this. It's your responsibility to take care of yourself. And it's just a matter of learning the little technique. If you go like this, you know, with it, it's not going to do anything. When you make it work like this, right, where it really is stimulating, that's where everything lights up. All the garbage comes out of your system. Your body can now get that area totally healed. So you're not just covering or making an injury feel better, you're removing the injury completely. And when you remove the problem, that doesn't bother you for the rest of your life. And it also prevents injuries. If you're a person who's doing a lot of physical work, working out of the gym, doing a lot of physical activities where you can twist or tear something, this prevents all that because it takes away all the adhesions and distortions out of your system. As you get older and you keep breathing more air, all these abrasives that you're breathing in from all the pollution gets into your system and wears you out. This gets rid of it. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. There's a lot more to the Activator than what I'm talking about, but that gives you a little seed to plant in your mind and go, what is that thing? Never heard of it before. If that was so effective, wouldn't everybody be using it? Well, they would if they knew what it was, but they've never heard of it. They don't even know about it. Who would think that something as simple as slapping your body on an area for 5 minutes until it gets all the crap out of it would actually be something that would heal your body profoundly with the true energy medicine that really doesn't cost anything at the end of the day. A little bit of time, a little bit of energy, a little bit of effort, a lot of courage, because no one likes pain and no one likes it when marks show up on their body. They think they're bad. But in this case, it's extremely good. And I can tell you, I've been doing this now for 7 years and I've seen major profound results with people. Anywhere I've shown people, injuries completely repaired permanently and all the congestion and inflammation being taken out of their body. All you got to do is just take responsibility for your body, do the right thing, find out more about this. I'm putting a little course out on this in the next little while and I've got some videos on it. So if you see me in some videos, you know, helping people with their treatment, teaching them how to do it for themselves, this is a self-care device. And there's areas, you can reach most areas in your body. If there's an area in your back where you can't reach, have somebody do it, and it will help you tremendously.
all three of us were original members of the Xenos group. We go back about 25 years. And Paul was a young developer when I first met him, and he had a major role to play in Xenos' success at building a technology that allowed us to print or view anything, anywhere, anytime.
So here at Grackle for the last 6 or 7 years, we've been formatting documents for the visually impaired using Google Workspace, making sure that they're formatted correctly and that anyone who has that visual impairment gets the document read to them correctly through whatever software they use for that. With the acquisition of AbleDocs, we can now expand that service outside of just the Google Workspace into any other type of document as well, especially straight onto PDF or Word documents too. And the great thing with our customers is that they talk about grackling a document, or the document has been grackled. And it's great to know that our software is synonymous with a well-formatted document that anyone with a visual impairment can actually read correctly.
Our commitment to quality assurance cements our status as a trusted provider of accessible documents. Happy customers are our pride.
So the great thing about working with AbleDocs is they have that deep accessibility experience, specifically around PDF, for example. They understand the specification. They know what it takes to make a document accessible. So we've been working with the AbleDocs team on what can we do to take that Grackle concept of making it really easy to speed up the process of making documents accessible.
So all of our customers have a legal requirement to make sure that documents and websites are accessible to blind people, but everyone knows it's the right thing to do as well. And what we do is actually make that accessible to a wider range of customers, because we can actually reduce their cost in doing that. So it's almost like democratizing accessibility.
So one of the challenges with making documents accessible is that it's very complex. It's very technical. For example, the PDF UA specification is a very technical document to understand how do you make a PDF accessible. On the development team side, we've been working with the AbleDocs team on the services side to figure out how can we make this process better and faster. The immediate impact of the AbleDocs acquisition for GrackleDocs is obviously just having a much bigger team. And a team of people, not just on the development side that can, you know, write code and develop products, which is obviously great, but also leveraging the knowledge of the AbleDocs services team. I think one of the problems in software development often is, but they're not focused on the end user. So we've taken that approach right from the beginning, and with some of the new development that we're doing, the tools that we're building for the services team, we're not only thinking of the services team as the end user for how they're going to use the software, but how is this going to be utilized when we deliver the content to our end customers as well.
Hey Jason, thanks for jumping on the call. Just wanted to talk to you about, now that we've kind of joined forces, we've got Grackle and AbleDocs all running together there, what do you think that's going to mean to our customers?
It's going to mean quite a bit, an extended suite of services and offerings. The way I look at it is this is just really a great step forward for digital accessibility as a whole. By bringing in, you know, the services and the softwares of both AbleDocs and GrackleDocs together, there's so much more that we can offer to both our existing loyal clients as well as new clients along the way.
Is there any concern from any of them about the takeover?
No concerns at all. If anything, this is great, because with the added abilities that we now have, it's just going to help them get their product and services faster, quicker, and better.
It's also good to know that you can make a living doing things that are good. This is a very good
That's
thing
true.
To be doing for humanity, for people who are visually impaired. And it's just, I remember Joey Lee, who joined us, and who is our principal developer, and he said to me fairly recently when we met, I like what you guys do. It's always good things that you are doing. You have good intentions.
PEMF, PEMA, Scalar Waves, what are you going to use? Come on down to the Tesla Medicine Show at the Redwood Theater and find out.
From the the base of the wrist, you will get two of the patient's fingers in place at the base of the thumb. These two fingers are over the styloid process, the radius. This point is directly located after the finger. So he takes, you notice there's a tiny hollow located in the styloid process of the wrist, which is located right here. Go to the most distal transverse wrist crease and we will draw a line. Approximately 1/10 width or 1/4 inch approximately distal from that is a second wrist crease. Drawing a line between the fourth and fifth fingers straight down to the second wrist crease will locate a point called heart 7. It's at the fourth intercostal, just below the nipple line. So if we slide down and find the first intercostal space, the second intercostal space, the third intercostal space, and the fourth intercostal space, and slide to the midline and press, it's quite tender. This point is called conceptual vessel 17.
I'm Dr. Jeffrey Hummel, and a cancer researcher and clinical cancer professional of 28 years. At Alumacell, we're advancing a type of red light phototherapy to beat cancer with light. What separates basic light therapy and photodynamic therapy is the combination of three elements: light, oxygen, and a photosensitive compound. Alumacell has developed breakthrough red light devices that can push therapeutic light energy deep into tissues to get at deeper cancers. Other lights can't reach these. They need surgery or endoscopic delivery. Alumacell combines this non-invasive light treatment with a natural amino acid that your body already makes, and it acts as a photosensitive payload to the target cancer cells. Our devices can treat most cancers with photodynamic therapy, or PDT.
The Alumacell approach to photodynamic therapy, or PDT, combines the power of our devices with the observation that most cancer cells can't break down the amino acid used as the photosensitive drug. A few hours after drug administration, photosensitive molecules are made in the body's cells. These molecules build up in the cancer cells, but not in the surrounding normal tissue. Alumacell's red light phototherapy can now preferentially target the cancer cells, causing a cytotoxic reaction that destroys them, while leaving the normal tissues unharmed.
These four things: patented technology, non-invasive deep tissue PDT, natural cancer treatment, and targeted cancer treatment give Alumacell significant and sought-after advantages over surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, and our competitors. Competing PDT solutions are only effective at treating superficial skin conditions. Competitors who treat disease at greater tissue depths, greater than 3 or 4 centimeters, rely heavily on invasive fiber optic light technologies and hospitalization. Alumacell PDT solves a lot of these problems. It's considerably less expensive, without any surgery. It involves minimal equipment, minimal overhead, and the treatments can be performed in under an hour and multiple times a week. This makes Alumacell treatments especially attractive to developing nations.
In the grand tapestry of nature, a delicate balance weaves life's intricate threads. At its heart lies the humble honeybee, a tireless guardian of this equilibrium. Through graceful dances, bees pollinate a symphony of blooms, nurturing the cycle that sustains our world. As petals give way to fruit, their delicate touch ensures abundance to our food supply. It's a crucial reminder that our fate is intertwined with theirs. But today, this balance is faltering more and more as bee populations face unprecedented challenges. Without a collective effort to rescue our bees and enhance biodiversity, we're headed for devastation on a global scale. But amidst the chaos, a solution has emerged. A rallying cry echoes, a call to protect these guardians of our food chain. Introducing 4R Bees, a technology-driven organization that is saving bees globally and organically every day. At 4R Bees, we understand the critical role that bees play in maintaining the balance of our ecosystem. Saving the bees is synonymous with saving our planet, and 4R Bees is at the forefront of this mission. Through our revolutionary PureWave technology, along with collaboration, community education, and our corridor pollinator initiatives, 4R Bees is saving and replenishing bee populations worldwide. Our continued research and development in PureWave technology is the fundamental engine of this movement, ensuring a brighter future for the bees and for our world. The path forward is clear. To save the planet, we must save the bees. But we can't do it without you. Every dollar pledged by you for 4R Bees products is directed straight towards our mission, including providing PureWave cells to more and more beekeepers worldwide, free of charge. As a dedicated supporter of 4R Bees, you're fostering bee health, supporting global ecosystems, and contributing to a harmonious environment for our planet. It's an unequivocal win-win situation for all. And at 4R Bees, we make the mission of saving bees fun for everyone. So what are you waiting for? Join this incredible movement today. Visit 4rbees.com to learn more about how you can save the bees and redefine the course of our future. 4R Bees, saving bees, saving the planet.
The human body consists of 70 trillion cells. Each of them is a bioelectric construct. Cell surfaces have positive electrical charges on the outside. The opposite pole is inside the cell, where negative charges accumulate on the cell membrane. This creates an electrical potential, the cell membrane voltage. A strong and healthy cell has a voltage field of minus 70 millivolts to minus 90 millivolts. This voltage field is used to control cellular processes. If it loses voltage, energy and function are reduced. Living conditions and bad habits may disturb the cellular electricity. Stress, hyperacidity, denaturized food, lack of vital substances, microbial pollution, electrosmog, environmental influences, mental stress, and lack of exercise lead to reduced cellular electricity. As a result, water and metabolic waste products remain in the cell. This can have far-reaching consequences. If, for example, blood vessel walls lose their tension and thus inflate, the flow radius in the vessels is reduced. The constriction and rouleau formation of the red blood cells reduce the transport of nutrients and oxygen. As a result, the supply and disposal of surrounding structures is severely restricted. Energy and function in organ and tissue structures deteriorate, an attack on health and well-being. Our patented sensor signals restore the charges on the cell surfaces. Cellular processes are accelerated and the cell regains its full power. The blood flow properties are optimized. Oxygen and nutrients can once again be transported into the smallest capillaries.
When the stars make you drool, just like a pasta fazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
My name is Candace Wilson. I'm an abstract artist here in Toronto. My art comes from stories, life experiences, and knowledge I have gained from traveling around the world. It expresses the inner and outer journeys I have taken. And the hope is that when people look at my art, they not only see my story, but that they will be inspired to take their own inner journey, setting them on a path of self-healing. Some years ago, I started to follow the teachings and meditative techniques of an Indian guru, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. And since then, I have been creating paintings that promote healing. According to these ancient Vedic teachings, chakras exist in various parts of the body, and each chakra acts as a wheel of rotating energy. When a chakra is blocked, people start to experience illness and dysfunction in that particular part of the body. Every chakra has a corresponding color, the use of which helps to unblock the chakra and make the person more receptive to healing. I am very conscious of the effects of the chakras and the associated colors when I create my art, and I also add gemstones, knowing through my study of Vedic healing that in doing so, the healing properties of the paintings will be enhanced. You don't have to know anything about healing, about abstract art, or my personal journey to be moved by my paintings, because art isn't about knowing, it's about feeling and finding the connection on a subconscious level. I've seen the effects of it time and time again. People who have spent hours just being with the paintings and feeling like they've been soothed by their presence or reinvigorated by their energy, not knowing that they are standing in front of art that heals. I feel like my art has now become bigger than merely a form of expression for me. It's become my way giving back to the world.
When you're working with the magic of Tesla medicine, anything is possible. It's a one, it's a zero, it's both at the same time.
This is the Centurion pulsed electromagnetic field system, therapy system, which is actually made in Canada. It's called the Easy System. Very simple control unit. It has different frequencies in it, 2, 8, 15, and 30. And the field intensity is set. You don't change the field intensity on it. And you can't adjust the time upwards of 60 minutes. We like this system because of the barrel design. This is called it's a coil design. It's like a Tesla coil, but it's like one of the bigger type of Tesla coils. I've always been intrigued by these, and a lot of the earlier European systems were actually designed like this with hoops. So most of them have been intended more for the practice setting, where people would put their arms or their legs or their abdomen or their chest, you know, hips, etc., into the barrel and lay on a bed to do their treatments. Well, I like this one because it's actually portable. You can actually use it at home yourself. Now, the magnetic field goes around, it's like a donut. So if you think of this as not being flat, but think of this as being like a donut, the magnetic field is actually pretty big. And in fact, actually, it extends out very wide. This is a field tester that I've used to demonstrate many other systems. And you can hear how loud it is because of the intensity. So if you go into the center of the system, that's where typically the field is about the strongest. But as you move closer to the edges, that's where the field is the strongest. But again, it's not only inside the barrel or this hoop that you feel the magnetic system, it actually extends quite a ways outwards. It's still pretty strong, even at about 3 feet away. Now, you can also demonstrate the field intensity, and the system comes with a magnet. And if you place the magnet, if you hold it loosely and put it up against the system, you probably will see it bouncing. I can feel it bouncing. That's how strong this magnetic system is. So the field intensity is what I would call a medium field intensity. High would be something like 20,000 Gauss. Low would be like 1 Gauss. This one is in the medium range. And so it's actually a very strong system. The design amplifies the magnetic field, so it concentrates it, makes it even more effective. So it can, as I said, it can be used for all sorts of applications. It doesn't matter whether it's medical or orthopedic, or inflammation of any kind anywhere. It can be used around the head. I'd be careful because of the field intensities. The frequencies, as I said, can be set. And these are brainwave level frequencies. So 2 is delta, 8 is theta, 15 is on the lower edge of alpha, beta, and then 30 is actual full beta. So you can use the system, you can decide which frequencies you want to use based on those brainwave patterns. And there's some discussion about those on our website. So to get more information on that, just look on the website for that information.
We start this amazing story about Ginger in the fall of 2021. She is a 14-year-old mare dealing with a condition that affects the nervous system and atrophies muscle, causing a loss of feeling in the body. As you can see, if the handler had not been leading her by the halter, she would have fallen. In the past, she had fallen several times and had to be picked up with the help of straps and a tractor. The owner had provided veterinarian-recommended care, but unfortunately, the need to put Ginger down was realized. Having purchased the Centropics Cloud and Vet Set, Darren started sessions on Ginger twice a day for 30 days. As Ginger's journey continues, by the beginning of December, she's showing amazing results, showing pep in her step and even better posture and gait. As you can see, the handler is no longer providing stability by holding a halter, but simply leading her. As the lead line is released, let's just watch and celebrate. While horse and buggy are the means of Amish travel, this picture and video shows Ginger proudly giving us an enjoyable ride in the countryside on a beautiful fall day. A bit of background story. In June of 2022, Ginger had been bred and received a well vet check and confirmation of a foal to arrive in the spring. On May 11th, 2023, at 1 a.m. in the morning, Ginger delivered a beautiful foal entirely on her own. Within a few seconds, this foal was on her feet, standing like she was hours old. Having been in her mother's womb for 11 months receiving cloud sessions, it's no wonder she is now so calm and willing to receive her own personal sessions at only 12 hours. Notice her reaction of licking, chewing, head dropping, and literally falling asleep. In honor of the product that saved Ginger, the foal was given the name Claudina. We celebrate Ginger's recovery and the blessing of new life.
Hey, Brendan with the Harmonetics Project. I'd like to talk for a few minutes about how Harmonetics has helped my life. But let me tell you a little bit about myself first. I was a airborne infantry medic with the 82nd, went on to be a flight medic and then a special operations medic all in the Army. I was deployed a couple times. And when I got out in 2016, I was having some problems. And about 2020, I was diagnosed with severe PTSD. Since that time, since 2020, I started my mental health journey. And I've done everything that I could think of and to try to help myself. I have done cold and hot therapies. I've done talk therapy for years now. I've done MDMA-assisted psychotherapy for PTSD through the VA. I meditate every day. I work out. I do all types of different stuff to find out what's going on with me and figure out how to live this life. One of the things that I did a lot with was breath work, and really worked on trying to process some of the traumas that I've dealt with. A lot of it's helped, a lot of it's been good, and I've had some serious realizations about myself and about what's going on with me. And that's helped me process some of this trauma. A lot of that trauma is very painful, and it comes up very explosively and hurts when it comes up. The thing with Harmonetics is it brings me into a space where I can relax and I can look at those same traumas or different traumas, ones that I haven't even processed. And instead of it's exploding and being this big ordeal that takes over and I have to distance myself from other people so that I can process it, with Harmonetics, I'm able to relax, look at that trauma, not let it explode inside of me, and kind of pick through it. It looks like when I'm doing it, it feels like a ball of string that's all bound up, and I'm just picking through one at a time, picking through and looking at it and seeing, okay, maybe I should do this differently. Oh, maybe I should do this differently. And it's amazing. It's been the most helpful thing that I've ever done in my life to help process my trauma and help get past and help be a better father, help be a better husband, help understand people around me, and just love more people in a way that I never have in my entire life, even before I went to war.
What is terahertz frequency? According to the Military Medical Research Volume 8, Article Number 28 of 2021, terahertz, THZ frequency, also known as the submillimeter wave, is a range of electromagnetic waves that falls between microwaves and infrared waves. This frequency range has been found to have many potential benefits for the human body when used in medical applications. One potential benefit of terahertz frequency is its ability to penetrate through various materials, including clothing, skin, and even some types of metal. This makes it an ideal frequency range for non-invasive imaging and sensing applications. Another benefit of terahertz frequency is its ability to stimulate cell growth and repair. Studies have shown that low-intensity terahertz radiation can promote wound healing, bone growth, and cartilage regeneration. This could have significant implications for the treatment of conditions such as osteoarthritis and bone fractures. Terahertz frequency also has potential anti-inflammatory and anti-tumor properties. Studies have shown that exposure to low-intensity terahertz radiation can inhibit the growth of cancer cells and reduce inflammation in the body. This could lead to new treatments for cancer and other inflammatory diseases. In addition to these medical benefits, terahertz frequency has also been found to have potential industrial and telecommunications applications. For example, it can be used in wireless communication systems to improve data transfer rate and reduce interference. It can also be used in industrial process control to detect and measure the properties of materials. In conclusion, terahertz frequency has many potential benefits for the human body when used in medical applications. Its ability to penetrate through various materials, stimulate cell growth and repair, and exhibit anti-inflammatory and anti-tumor properties makes it a promising area of research for the development of new medical treatments and technologies. The iTeraCare's terahertz technology. The iTeraCare device uses targeted frequencies that penetrate up to 30 centimeters into the body with zero discomfort or irritation. Every cell of the body has a frequency measured in hertz. Terahertz resonates at the same frequency as healthy human cells, generating millions of vibrations per second. Electromagnetic waves of the terahertz waves are currently being used as a biophysical factor in medicine to correct several disorders. Grab your iTeraCare device now for a healthier, happier, and beautiful you.
Nikola Tesla taught us that if you want to know the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. Come join us at the Tesla Medicine Show at the Redwood Theater this June 14th, 15th, and 16th.
I want to introduce you to a revolutionary technology that's transforming lives, the RASHA, the Reciprocal Antenna Scalar System for Holographic Activation. Imagine a world where your mental, physical, and spiritual well-being are in perfect harmony. That's the world the RASHA creates. In our fast-paced life, stress, health issues, and a lack of mental clarity are common challenges. Traditional methods of addressing these issues are often fragmented and don't always provide holistic solutions. The Rasha is not just a machine. It's a gateway to a balanced and enhanced state of being. It's a unique technology that harmonizes your body, mind, and spirit using advanced scalar energy fields, base 12 sound frequency therapy, and bioregenesis techniques. Utilizing scalar energy and specialized base 12 sound frequencies, the Rasha creates an environment that promotes deep relaxation, cellular regeneration, and mental clarity. It's like giving your body and mind a reset button, aligning you with your organic, eternal state of balance. Experience a profound sense of relaxation and stress release. Enhance your focus, creativity, and cognitive functions. Strengthen your body's natural self-healing abilities. Reduce pain and fatigue. Gain a deeper connection with your inner self and the world around you. From athletes seeking peak performance to business professionals looking for mental clarity and individuals seeking a deeper spiritual connection, the Rasha has been a game changer. Our clients consistently report transformative experiences. Join the ranks of those who have elevated their lives with the Rasha. Whether you're a health center, a sports club, or an individual seeking a holistic approach to well-being, the Rasha is your answer. Let's embark on this journey of transformation together. Contact us to experience the Rasha firsthand. You're not investing in a product, you're investing in a healthier, more balanced, and eternal version of yourself. I'll be here to guide you on this transformative journey.
A lot of people do not really feel like wireless technology is any problem at all.
But I can present to you case after case after case of malignant glioblastoma, lymphoma, metastatic carcinoma.
They don't feel any effects of it. All they see is the upside.
If we knew that a cell phone tower is going to be installed in a given location, it would be very nice to do studies before it is installed and then study patients again after they have been exposed to cell phone towers.
When you look at the data and you look what's happening with infertility, cancer, DNA damage, I mean, we've got to do something for our future generations. And just seeing these young people that we're seeing already.
If you interview these patients and you talk to them, they'll tell you about cell phone use next to their head.
The problem is that physicians are not trained to ask these questions.
We need to listen to the scientists. We need to believe the scientists that are doing the EMR research.
Most physicians are not really familiar with brain scanning, and the brain scans we do are functional brain scans.
The controversy intrigued me because whenever there's scientific controversy, it tells me that scientists haven't figured things out, and it means we can learn something.
Wireless radiation isn't benign. It's a blessing, and it's also a curse.
We are under the illusion that wireless radiation is safe because we can purchase it.
The signals that are used by 5G are essentially beamformed, which means they are aimed at the particular user. And in my opinion, this irregularity in exposure is a physiological stress that has grave consequences, such as endocrine disruption.
Over time, this harm can accumulate. It's very similar to chemical toxins.
Just knowing what is emitting, what frequencies, and how that's affecting people is critical for doctors. If they're not aware of this environmental pollutant and the consequences of this environmental pollutant, they're going to misdiagnose their patients.
Dr. Ray said to me, "This is your generation's tobacco." He told me this 10 years ago, and I think he's right.
So Tetra speakers for me is a lifelong pursuit of perfection in music. The artists certainly give it their all, and when it comes to speakers, that's what Tetra Speakers does. That's what I do, no stone unturned, to get to that last note, that last little symbol in the back corner. When I design a speaker, I'm not thinking about how it's ultimately going to look, but how it's going to react to the crossover and the components we put inside. So it is supposed to not add or take anything away. So therefore, you won't find any boxes in Tetra. Everything's got a shape to it. And when you think about instruments, there isn't any box-shaped instruments except Bo Diddley's guitar. And that was a gimmick, right? But it worked. It worked for him. Maybe the hurdy-gurdy, right? But when you put a box in a room, which is a box, you're actually creating problems. So then you have to now treat the room to deal with the fact that you have these reflections everywhere that are multiplying each other and interfering with the music. So you really do, when you do it properly and you pull all the elements together, it's like making a guitar or an instrument that plays all the instruments, because it's not just a guitar. It's a drum, it's a bass, it's the singer, it's the cymbal over here, it's the background singer over here. And you want every one of those things to have its space and time as it was recorded. And you want to feel like, hey, I'm in the studio with those musicians.
Since 1984, Professor Emeritus Abram Liebhoff, world-famous expert on cosmic rays, has been demonstrating how the diamagnetic field can combine with oscillating magnetic signals to significantly affect the human body through a beneficial phenomenon known as ion cyclotron resonance-like effect. Liebhoff was Dean of the Department of Physics at Auckland University, credited with 111 research papers, more than 24 patents, and around 3,400 academic citations during his career.
Since the time of Pasteur and Koch and later Watson and Crick, we have been basically dealing with chemistry as a means of treating the body for various illnesses. Now, to a large extent, this has been interpreted by biologists and doctors as being the only way to treat living things. However, I think that this is an incomplete story. I think that the use of chemistry is going to be replaced by the use of electromagnetism, to where we think in terms of living things as being electromagnetic entities with their own fields that are attached to them, that they grow with, that are basically derived from evolution. In other words, all the species have similar electric fields. Each species has a different.
The human body is pervaded with electromagnetic signals, observable, for example, in the heart with an electrocardiogram, or in the brain with an electroencephalogram. As living species evolved, they were constantly bathed in energy in a range of frequencies from the diamagnetic field. Psychics' devices imitate the harmonic electrical fields of nature and represent an advanced expression of ion cyclotron resonance-like technology. They are capable of modulating their output field in order to re-equilibrate cellular metabolism with customized treatment emissions according to the needs and constitution of each individual.
Nikola Tesla is not only celebrated in the US or in Canada. Nikola Tesla, his name is known throughout the entire world. He's in the neighborhood of 300 patents in his lifetime. Those patents cover over 26 countries. It starts with the induction motor. That invention in itself is probably one of the most important inventions when it comes to power generation. That induction motor used electromagnetism, and that really is the start of power generation. George Westinghouse recognized that Nikola Tesla was a brilliant inventor. He reached out to Tesla. He bought the patents from him, then worked with Tesla, had him work within his company to further develop the AC system. Westinghouse, Tesla, they together designed this hydroelectric facility on the American side. Now you step back to 1892, where William Birch Rankin created a company in 1901 to 1905. The same company, although renamed Canadian Niagara Power, they then tackle creating the same plant. With some improvements, they put that all into the plant behind me today. This particular facility has, that we know of, 9 patents from Tesla that have to do with the AC generator. There's 3 patents on the transformers, polyphase transformers. And then there's an additional group of patents that were related to power generation, power distribution. He is an incredible inventor. Through an attraction like the Niagara Parks Power Station, where we can celebrate Nikola Tesla's patents, we can celebrate the coming together of Tesla and the company of Westinghouse and the creation of the equipment. Children will be inspired. Everybody will be inspired to hopefully become the next Tesla.